Well, howdy.
Back on the horses' heads, and I'm going to redo this one because it's what the last head I did yesterday, and I was demoing for some ladies who came to my studio, and I may have worked a little too fast on this one, and I'm not happy with it. Put it on the neck. Okay. can hit a lot better now. These, it's so small that if I focus in on what I'm working on, as soon as I move the sculpture, you'll go right out of the picture. So I apologize if you can't see it very well. What I'll do is let the clay set up a little bit before I come back to it. This clay gets real soft when it's heated up, and it may be too soft for me to work on right now, so I'll keep working down the line of horses. Put some chest muscles on them. There we go. Gotta fill in behind that leg. Before I take it to the foundry, I'm going to go over all this and fill any deep gaps. Okay, now I'll do this horse head here. Yeah, that turned out really good. I'm happy with that. What's going to make or break it is the mane. And I wish I had a cameraman here that could zoom in on what I'm doing, but I don't have that luxury. Okay. Re-angle his head a little bit. There we go. And we'll put that in the vise. If you get a little fly tying vise, might be helpful for your sculpting if you're doing something small and you got to do it away from the sculpture. I did work on, let me get my camera here. I worked on this horse right here, and I'm kind of happy the way his head turned out. As you can see it from the different angles here, I'm going to be working on this head here, and I'm going to rework some of these other heads a little bit, but that one I'm happy with. All right, everybody, that's going to be it for tonight.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.